Good afternoon and welcome back to Valkyrie testing. Today we're going to do some full throttle motor testing with the wing on. That's right, we got the wing on, but I'm probably going to say that in the next clip anyway because I'm recording the intro after the fact because I don't plan my vlogs very well. So anyway, let's get to the cool part.
Okay. We just got the wing on last night. So this will be the first run-up test with the wing on full throttle. Slide this or point it a little bit more out the door here. That's better. Okay, let's start plugging motors in. We got happy tones from all six motors. And I just gotta hold on to the nose up here. Let's see what happens. That's a lot of force. I don't think, let's try and put my hand in front of the inlet here. I don't want to block the inlet at all. It sounds very different from the full throttle run without the wings on. Let me try one more time.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think my kitchen scale that goes up to 11 pounds is going to work to measure the thrust of this. So we'll have to think of something else.
So we just watched the footage that you just watched for the first time, and I noticed something on the video that I didn't notice when I was actually doing the test because I was on the other side of the camera, and I couldn't see under the body the way I can see in the video here, and I noticed something that some of you may have noticed. The main gear doors, when I got to a higher throttle setting, started to close, and they didn't close all the way because they ran into the main gear strut. And that confirms that the main gear hole is acting as an auxiliary inlet, letting more air flow into the inlet cavity, which is a good thing. More air, available to the engines, especially on takeoff, that's going to be good. But it's not good if the gear doors move in and close all by themselves. But one of the main differences with this run versus an actual flight is that the gear door servos were not plugged in because they're on a separate receiver and a separate power source. So they were just freewheeling in this particular run. So this shows me that I need to do another test with those servos powered on to see if they will hold the doors open.
All right, as you can hear, the gear door servos are now plugged in and crying because they're trying to hold the doors open. So let's see what happens. Happy tones from all the motors. Here we go.
Okay, after watching the second test back on video, I could see a little bit of flex in the gear door. Mostly, you could see it bounce back when I throttle down. If you watch real close, you can see it kind of creep up as I throttle up, but it's more evident when I reduce the throttle quickly that the door sort of flexes back open wider. Now, the main gear wheels are pretty close when they retract to that door, so I do think I need to increase the clearance a bit, either by changing the kinematics a bit, like lengthening that pushrod arm, or shave. No, that's really the only way. I gotta make the doors open a little bit wider so that there's some clearance there for the wheels as they retract. So that's what we'll have to do. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.